Okay, so one of the most important things about this process is making sure your masking holds really tight. So I use TransferWrite 592U High Tack Masking. It is a paper masking. It's really the only one I've used. I did try a green something before and I didn't care for it as much. So this one I get at US Cutter. I also use a brayer to apply my masking. So I use this one from Cricut. I had it left over from when I was doing some Cricut stuff. So I roll it on, I apply a lot of pressure, and I make sure that it is really adhered to my wood before I go and I score and cut it. So now we will go ahead and score and cut, and I'll come back and show you the process of weeding and spraying with the shellac and spray paint. Okay, so we are all scored for the backer. Now the backer is set up so that we are spray painting the stars. That way you can remove the star and they're kind of all connected. So if you're really careful, they may come off all at once. You may have to clean up some of the little bits. I have a weeding tool, it's super dirty, sorry. Again, Cricut. Dental tools also work. So we are going to just carefully pull up on the masking. We're gonna try to grab as much as we can all at once. It will rip. But if you're careful, you can get a lot all at once and don't have to clean up too much. So you see how they're all connected. Well, we can go back. Grab the little star, come over here. You definitely don't want to grab the background pieces because that would take forever to take up. Okay, so that really wasn't so bad, right? So now that we've done that, so now we're going to roll it down again, just to make sure everything's down there really tight. And then we're going to grab our bullseye shellac. Dries really fast. That's kind of why, one of the reasons why I like using it. And what this is going to do, this is going to seal. So we've scored little lines in our wood, right? So what that's done is it's opened up your wood grain so that paint could seep in underneath where we don't want it. So what the shellac is doing is it's sealing your wood grain so that things can't seep where we don't want it to go. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and spray it. My spray paint is acting funny recently. I don't think it's clogged. Okay, so we've got that. And then I just real quick go over it one more time just to make sure that nothing's like raised with the paper, just real lightly. And you can see there's a little bit of a sheen on the board. So we're gonna let that dry for about 10 minutes and then we're gonna come back and add our color. Okay, so we feel pretty dry just because I'm nervous and anxious about it. I always like to roll it one more time just to be safe. And I am using Montana Gold spray paint. This color is Nautilus. I find that compared to some of the other brands, this does not seem to run. Like I've used this in the past and this one likes to seep more for whatever reason. I don't know if it's because it's a artist spray paint, that it's an acrylic. I'm not sure why, but this just seems to stay where I want it. And FYI, don't get it at Michael's because it's super overpriced there. I find Blick is the best place. Blick Arts store is one of the best places to buy it because it's cheaper. The other thing to note also is when you buy this, you can buy different size caps. They're different colors. I need to clean that one. And then you also can buy an aerosol can that has acetone in it to clean your caps. So it's, they're a pretty cool spray paint. So let's go ahead and spray our boards. So I just go through and give it a light coat, and then we'll come back. Make sure we get it fairly uniform. Okay, now we're gonna let this dry. I think we look pretty good. How do we look? You guys have a nice shine on the camera, so it's hard to see. But I think we're pretty even. You can see some of where the masking is, but I think overall, our design's pretty well covered. Okay, so we're pretty dry. There's a few different ways we could take this masking up. We could use our weeding tool. We could use tape. We could use a scraper. It's really whatever you prefer. I've not really used a scraper before, so I'm gonna try. I usually use it only on acrylic, but I was like, you know what? We might as well try it on this and see how it goes. So, take up all of our masking. It's looking pretty darn good so far. Very clean lines. Don't see any issues, which is exciting. So we'll go through and get all these taken up. Let's try, see what happens when we tape. The only thing I'm a little worried about is I don't want to pull up the paint I already did. So let's see what happens. So if we do it right here, let's see what happens. If we just carefully pull it up. Yeah, see, we might take up some of our paint if we do that. So I don't think we're gonna do that. Let's go ahead and keep using this guy. So I don't want to affect our paint. Now if we did, I did a really light score on this. If we did a deeper score, I think it would look even prettier. But that's totally up to you and how much time you want to spend scoring your designs. We just go through and scrape, scrape, scrape. It's looking pretty good, I think. We can grab our frames from the, oops, I just smeared my paint because it wasn't dry. So we're gonna have to see if we can get that fixed. All right, so I just used a little baby wipe and I rubbed on that spot and it took it right up. So problem averted. Okay, so let's keep going. I will get this all weeded and then we'll come back and finish up with the reindeer. But as you can tell, the pattern is on there really pretty. Now, another option, if we wanted, actually, this might be fun to try. If we wanted, we could use this tape and then we could lightly sand the whole thing to give it maybe like a little bit of an aged look. Let's try that. You guys know I like to play. Let's do this. So let's, ooh, you know what else we could do? Oh, now we're having fun. All right, so we're gonna use this. We're gonna pull up all of our masking and then we're gonna see, welcome to the brain of Robin. Okay, we're gonna do this and then we're going to just lightly sand it, even though it's looking like perfect. Okay, but I have an idea and I wanna try it, so why not? Okay, so here's my, this is my 220 grit. I'm just gonna lightly go over it. And then I think I'm gonna actually test using some paint with a baby wipe, because you guys know I love baby wipes. So let's just give it just a little, we're just gonna go over it. Oop, I missed a spot right there. Let's pull that up. You can see the masking. I'm just gonna age it a bit, and you can see the, spray paint is wanting to move a little bit. That's okay. I actually think it looks pretty. All right. Let's go through and clean it up a bit. Oh, there's another piece I missed. Now, do we go dark? Maybe I should go dark. Like a dark brown. That might be pretty. Shoot, guys. I keep changing my mind. Now I want to do a stain again. Okay, I'm doing a stain. Hold on, I'm going to go grab one. Okay, all right, so I'm back. I grabbed walnut gel stain. I'm going to try this because I think this is, could be really cool. And no, I've not done this before. So we're going to do this together for the first time. So we're going to, we're just going to apply the gel stain over the backer, right over the paint. I am using a baby wipe, so it's not going on as dark. Oh my gosh, that's actually really pretty. I'm obsessed. Now the question is, did I go dark enough or light enough? I can hear my air compressor in the background. Did I go dark enough or light enough with the stain to offset the reindeer? That's the question. I realize my camera is bouncing a bunch, so I apologize. Ugh, that is beautiful. Okay, I love this. That's really pretty. All right, what do you guys think? Okay, so let's check our deer. Check him. We'll set this off to the side, let it dry. Let's take up our masking, see how he did, how he fared. Remember, we painted him white. Can you see him? I don't know if you can see him. I may have to go a little darker on my gel stain. May not be the right color, but once I add additional covering of shellac, it might be okay, because this will get darker. So let's go ahead and take off his tail, get in the E or the B part, take off this. All right, oh, it's looking good. Let's take off this part of the E. Grab his antlers. Little spot right there. Boop. Take off the loop and V. So this, I think, is cool because it gives you the illusion of it all being cut. Like some people make the monograms, you know, but it's all connected, so you don't have to deal with all the crazy gluing. Now we do have to do with the weeding, but we don't have to deal with the gluing. So it's a catch-22, right? Okay, So there he is. So let's darken him up a little bit. So we're going to go ahead and do some more shellac on, or do shellac on the deer. And you'll notice he will get richer. Let's see what it looks like once we do this. Okay, we're gonna let that dry. But we can set them on top just to see if we like it. And I think I do. I think that's really pretty. And we could have gone lighter. We could go back. We could age it more if we wanted. We could even do chippy paint if we wanted. We could add like white and do chippy paint around the edges. That could be cool. I might try that in a little bit. So that is basically how you make one of these and how you do the backer, along with a little bit of extra that I decided to try. I hope you guys found that helpful. And if you want to grab this file, it'll be in the link below. Thanks so much for watching.